We're going to continue our program. This is an extension of that. And before continuing our program, again, I would like to call everybody for 1 minute of silence for the martyrdom of the Battle of Gallipoli. I want to thank our ambassador, Serdar Kılıç, for opening the residency for us and having gathered over here. As you all know, as I mentioned in our conference, this is a very special year for us, which is the 100th year of anniversary of Battle of Gallipoli. This event is so crucial. As you all know, it was the base for foundation of the Turkish Republic. And today, if I am being able to speak in the Turkish embassy, if we are all together in front of the Turkish flag, that's because of the victory of the Battle of Gallipoli. So this is how important it is. So with that, I would like to invite our ambassador, Serdar Kılıç. Thank you.
Distinguished executives and members of ATAA, esteemed representatives of the Turkish American community, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me a great pleasure to host you at our embassy on the occasion of the 35th annual convention of the Assembly of Turkish American Associations. Since its establishment in 1979, ATAA has been playing an important role in further advancing the partnership between our two great nations, as well as in successful integration of the Turkish American community in the United States. I believe that ATAA's contribution in facilitating cross-cultural experiences and interfaith cooperation are equally important, particularly as we continue to grapple with racism, xenophobia, intolerance, and Islamophobia around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, Turkish-American relations have always been one of the most significant pillars of the Turkish foreign policy. For over 60 years, our two countries have stood together as allies and partners to make the world a better and safer place and to uphold our shared values of democracy, freedom, human rights, and the rule of law. As NATO allies, we successfully defended the free world and prevailed in the Cold War. Since the fall of the Iron Curtain, we have been continuing to work together in support of international peace and security in a vast geography stretching from the Balkans and Caucasus to the Middle East and Central Asia. Our geography continues to be ridden with a number of crises: civil war and humanitarian tragedy in Syria, violent extremism and sectarian tensions in the Middle East, Daesh and other terrorist organizations in the region. By the way, as you might have noticed, I didn't refer to that terrorist organization as ISIL because I don't want to imply that it's an Islamic state or somehow represents Islam. It has nothing to do with the religion of Islam. It's just a terrorist organization. The continuing threat of proliferation of weapons of mass destruction and their means of delivery, the painful political transition in North Africa, and the crisis in Ukraine, to name only a few. The complex nature of these crises testify to the fact that we need an even stronger US-Turkey partnership to effectively counter them. That's why our strategic partnership with the United States is now even more essential than ever before. Distinguished participants, the theme of this year's convention is Turkish Americans Unite, Challenges and Opportunities. I wholeheartedly support this theme and the timely call for unity and solidarity among the Turkish Americans. Indeed, the Turkish American community will continue to derive its strength from its sense of unity and common purpose. I sincerely hope that this conference will make an important contribution to the further strengthening of our unity and solidarity among the members of the Turkish American community. Ladies and gentlemen, today we also take the opportunity to commemorate the 100th anniversary of one of the fiercest battles in contemporary history, namely Çanakkale or Dardanelles. We respectfully remember all the soldiers who made the ultimate sacrifice on both sides of the battle. As you know, March 18, 2015 marks the centenary of our naval victory in Çanakkale. And next month, we will commemorate the 100th anniversary of the land battle and the Anzac Day, which had been critical for the nation-building processes of Turkey as well as that of Australia and New Zealand. Every year, thousands of people from Great Britain, Australia, and New Zealand come to Çanakkale to pay tribute and respect for their fallen soldiers. We proudly note that this bloody and painful page of our common history is now a strong symbol of friendship and solidarity between our countries. I would like to conclude by once again expressing our gratitude to ATAA, its component associations, as well as to our American friends for their efforts, for their relentless efforts, I should say, in further advancing US-Turkey relations and improving the status of our citizens and kinsmen in this country. I wish you all a very successful conference. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ambassador Selakovic. Now, I would like to actually invite a very special person who is the only person, the first person who has traveled the whole world with a rowboat, Erdem Eruç. Erdem Bey, would you come to the platform, please? Thank you very much. First of all, we're going to actually give an award to Erdem Eruç for his contribution to the Turkish American community, actually for the whole Turks in the whole world. So maybe. Are we done? Thank you.
This is a great honor for me to receive this award and to follow our esteemed ambassador on the podium. The award is actually Turkish American of the Year. It's a big one. It makes me kind of nervous right now to stand in front of you and talk. I want to introduce myself a little bit to you. I live in Seattle. My name is Erdem Eruç, and I am the first person to have circumnavigated the world by human power solo. I am the first one to have rowed the three oceans of the world. I am the first one to have rowed the complete Indian Ocean. I am the first one to have spent the longest time at sea, 312 days alone on the Pacific Ocean. The list goes on. I made it into the 2009, 2012, and 2014 Guinness Books of Record, and more records are on their way because I am planning to row from New York on May 19th, a special day in Turkey, Youth and Sports Day, which is also the day that Atatürk landed at Samsun to start the independence war. On 19th of May, weather pending, we will leave from New York with an Australian friend. We will be flying on the rowboat, multiple flags, those of New Zealand, Australia, and Turkey, and aim for Morocco. When we get to Morocco at about 85th day, on about 85th day, there, pending resolution of my Schengen visa problems, we will take on board a British Australian friend, so the British flag will be added onto the boat as well. We will rotate the flags at Gallipoli. During the Gallipoli campaign 100 years ago, the British, the Turks, well, Ottomans, New Zealanders, Australians, Indians, the Gurkhas were there. The Senegalese, the French, brought them there. And the French themselves, they were fighting. And this year, in April, 25th of April, multi-flag ceremonies will be held. Warships from all these countries will be there. My intention was to be there together with my yellow rowboat, but it had to be this year. So while on the water, rowing out of New York, we will be rowing, battling the challenge of the ocean, blogging about our time on the water, while at the same time remembering 100 years prior the challenges that the soldiers faced during that time. It is an important battle, cost about 500,000 casualties, dead, wounded, and sick, captured, all of it, were sidelined. It was a costly battle on all sides. It tied up all resources of the Ottoman Empire that could have been used elsewhere. It tied up resources of the British, which could have been used on the Western Front. It shut down the supply lines to Russia, ending up in the downfall of the Tsar, and prolonging the war on the Western Front to 4 years. It was costly all around. It was a war that should not have happened. And that's really the message that we will be driving home. With my Australian friend and then the British friend, we'll be talking about peace, blogging about peace. And we will be emphasizing the message that because there exists an environment of cooperation and peace today, we can do things together and collaborate on such a project. If there were peace among all nations, there would be more projects produced between those nations as well. I circumnavigate the globe, fully relying on the goodwill of strangers, and I was given the citation of merit from the Explorers Club for the year 2013. And with that, I have the responsibility to take the message of peace that I was delivered to the rest of the world. So my message will be on this journey, one of peace. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Erich. I guess please continue and conversations and get to know each other and have good food. Thank you.